Hi guys, welcome back with me, Ciao Ciao 2025, and that's the main Stable Diffusion. Today we're going to learn about LoRA and Stable Diffusion. LoRA is kind of a mini models, that it's a model between the models. For example, if you have checkpoint or models, but you want to have like a certain clothing, a certain pose, or a certain character to be in your image, you could add a LoRA there. So it's some kind of add-ins that add more to your model. First, we're going to learn about how to set up LoRA. To do that, you go to the extension, and then from here, you select available. You just load this and you search for LoRA. If you're using, like me, Automatic 111, it's usually already built in, so you cannot find LoRA here, but you're gonna find it here. And then just apply and restart UI. That's as simple as that. When the model restart, now you have LoRA. And how to use it? It has like this show hide extra network. You click here and then you select LoRA. Here will show all the LoRA that you have. First, we need to download a LoRA models. Where to download it? You could go to CFIT AI again. In CFIT AI screen, you could search for LoRA here. Just as simple as click the filter, select SD15, and select LoRA. So it's going to show only LoRA here. So there's a lot of LoRA. Like I said, there's a character, style, celebrity, clothing, best models, and whatever. For example, this is Rolla for Skin Sexer. This is LoRA for Genshin Impact character and other stuff. To make it simple, let's select character. And let's select someone that are maybe not anime style. Maybe celebrity. Make it more obvious, you know. Okay, Emily Root. This is a news model. I like One Piece, and you will have this. Just simply download this. When you download LoRA, you will have this self-tensor file, Emily Root 2 in this case. Let's just cut here, go to Web UI, go to Models, and go to LoRA. Okay, we got Emily Root LoRA. Back to our current Stable Diffusion screen. Now go back to here. The screen is empty, right? Just refresh this. Refresh. Yeah. Now we have Emily Root LoRA. How to use it? Sometimes depending on the LoRA itself. So for context, you could see this. Is there any trigger words like this? It has trigger word. It means you need some word to use it, like Emily Root, Naomi, a woman with red hair. You could copy paste this thing, or simply Emily Root. Now back to here. Have this LoRA click. Emily Root 2. This is the LoRA power. The more power it is, the more unflexible the image, 0.5 or 0.7. Let's see. Let's generate. I use cosplay mix here. I don't know what kind of model is that. But let's make a sample of models. Okay, this is how the image turned out to be. It's become Emily Root, Nami, a woman with red hair. This, you could make it because you have this LoRA. If we delete this LoRA, and it's gonna generate a different image, even though we use the same sheet. I should use the same sheet, damn it. I forgot. Okay, later we're going to use the same sheet. Okay, let's generate this girl, a woman with red hair, okay? It's not, obviously, it's not Emily Root. We use the same seed. Here, and we add the LoRA again. Let's undo this. It's gonna produce Emily Root, because the LoRA is there. And here is the picture. I generate very simple prompt with low resolution image just to make it fast. Now we produce amiloroid again because we ate this LoRA, even though we have like the same seed. But that's the power of LoRA. Use the models that write for you. Play the negative and the positive for better picture. Of course, but you know, I'm being lazy. Thank you for watching. I hope it helps and have a nice day.